Once they're back on the bed, you remove the pail, cover it up, step away from me, and check COCA, which is color, odor, character, amount. If there was blood, foul odor, if there was floaty, something wrong, just be very vague and tell her you're leaving it in the bathroom for the nurse to check. Once the nurse checks abnormalities, you dump, clean, and return according to facility policy. You can say facility policy, you can say company policy. I've seen students get nervous and say, how my job wants me to. All of those are correct. What she will not take is Clorox or Lysol or something along that. Because if you look at the rationale, every facility cleans it different. So just tell her you're cleaning the equipment according to facility policy. Once that clean and put away, take off your gloves, wash your hands, get a washcloth for the resident to wash their hands, and you're gonna wash your hands again as part of your final steps. The next procedure is bedpan fracture pan. I'm just gonna start by saying, watch the video. This one is very, very picky and very tedious, and I'm gonna kind of highlight it, but if you're not using them a lot where you're working, go ahead and review on the video. But this one is a lot of head up, head down. There's nothing you can do about it. Put the gloves on, lay the head flat, turn them on their side, put them on the bedpan, check for placement. Give them the call light, give them the toilet tissue, and raise the head of the bed. People cannot go to the bathroom by laying flat. Once you leave and return when called, anti-spill number one, lower the head of the bed. Anti-spill the bedpan number two, hold that bedpan flat while they roll over. You put the bedpan at the foot, you wipe from front to back. Change your gloves, wash your hands, put them back into supine, and do perineal care if necessary. Cover the pan, take it to the bathroom, check color, odor, character, amount. Leave it in the bathroom for the nurse if something's wrong. Dump, clean, and return according to facility policy, and it's the same ending. Take off your gloves, wash your hands, wash the resident's hands, wash your hands again as part of your final steps. Now, urinal isn't quite as tedious. For urinal, raise the head of the bed, put your gloves on. All you have to do is offer me the urinal. But if you do have to place it, handle goes up. Hand the call light, hand the toilet tissue, leave, return when called. Remove the urinal, cover it up, take it to the bathroom, check COCA, color, odor, character, amount, report unusual findings to the nurse. Dump, clean, sanitize, return according to company policy. Take off your gloves, wash your hands, wash their hands, wash your hands again as part of your final steps. Next up is empty urinary drainage bag. So that's the Foley bag or the catheter bag. That's this procedure. Put on your gloves, grab the graduated cylinder, which is the big triangle cylinder, and a piece of paper towel. Don't put your knees on the floor. So you have got to kind of squat to do this procedure. If you put your knees on the floor, you get an infection control caution. So you're going to remove the spout, aim it in the center or in the middle without touching the sides. Unclamp it, drain it, clamp it, put it back, cover it up, take it to the bathroom, and it's the same story. Color, odor, character, amount, report unusual findings to the nurse, dump, clean, sanitize, return according to facility policy, and do your final steps. I have not seen urine or stool specimen collection come up. Does not mean it won't, it just means I haven't seen it. So just review those procedures. But application for an incontinent brief does come up for the state test. To summarize this procedure, you're going to completely remove the brief. So you've got your gloves on, completely take the brief completely off, do perineal care, change your gloves, new gloves on, and then completely put the new brief back on. If you have any questions and you're not sure, refer back to the video. Next procedure is unoccupied bed, so nobody is in the bed. No gloves for this procedure. For the state test, they're not incontinent. And you need to bring the bed up to a workable height, which is gonna be at about your waist. To strip the bed, you're gonna start at the top, roll everything down to the foot, put it in a dirty spot of the room. Two choices, foot of the bed or the seat of the chair. You're making the bed, so just put them in the seat of the chair. Make half the bed at a time lengthwise. So fitted sheet, then top sheet, then blanket, miter the corner, then go to the other side of the bed, pull all your linens over, and miter the other side. Put the pillowcase on by turning it inside out and pulling the pillow up over, and the opening has to go away from the door. You have two types of unoccupied beds. An open unoccupied bed, you walk the top sheet all the way down, bring it halfway back up. And a closed bed looks like when you first walk into a motel or hotel, so it's home. The blanket's kind of up over the pillow, all tucked in. At the foot of the bed, make sure you do a toe pleat so that way they don't get sores on the tops of their toes. Do your final steps. For occupied bed, again, for the state test, they're not incontinent, so no gloves. All of these procedures you can watch individually as you need to. But to summarize this procedure, you're going to put the side rails up. You're going to bring the bed up to a workable height and lower the side rail that you're standing on. Drape the resident by unfolding the bath blanket over, grab the sheet and the blanket, roll it down to the foot, and remove it. Only the fitted sheet is going to be changed under the resident. So there are no draw pads, there's no incontinent pads, just a fitted sheet for your stay test. So once you've removed the top sheet and blanket, you've got them draped, turn them on their side, loosen up the fitted sheet, tuck it snug against their back, put the clean fitted sheet next to it. Raise the side rail, go to the other side of the bed, lower the side rail, have them turn onto the clean fitted sheet, pull the fitted sheet down, remove it, raise the side rail back up, put your fitted sheet at the foot of the bed. Unfold the top sheet and blanket over the drape, roll the drape down, miter the corners, pull up on the toes, and change the pillowcase by turning it inside out over your arm. And again, I remind you, you can go back to the individual procedure and see the whole thing done. Do your final steps.